Dankum privetsvet vas.
Today we talk about Russian unmanned combat vehicle tests in Syria. In early May, Russian Ministry of Defense announced Uran-9 vehicle was operational with the Russian army and was successfully tested in Syria. Uran-9 is the first large custom-designed unmanned vehicle to be tested in actual combat operations. It is the successor to the Uran-6 vehicle, a mine-clearing robot, from which it inherited some chassis design features. Allegedly, Uran-9 operates in teams of 3 to 4 vehicles. With its relatively heavy weaponry, it should be effective both at short and long-range engagements, both in the urban environments and out in the open. In Syria, it was always operated by humans as it has no combat AI of its own, save for limited target assist software. During the 10th All-Russian Scientific Conference, a report was disclosed about performance of Uran-9 in those Syrian deployments. Even though the manufacturer claims control distance to be up to 3 kilometers, the average range of managed control was much less when around low-rise buildings blocking the signal. Furthermore, cases of complete loss of signal were reported, though it was not said in what number of missions they occurred. Also, it was concluded that the chassis of Uran-9 cannot be used in combat roles and requires field repair. Supporting and guiding rollers and suspension springs were especially problematic. Report further stated that the optics and targeting devices frequently failed at detecting the enemy and gave out multiple interferences on the ground and in the air. One of the big issues was also the fact that, by design, armament and sighting devices on the vehicle are not stabilized, so their use from a moving vehicle is not really possible. Overall operation of the 30mm cannon was reported as unstable. Finally, it was concluded that the Uran-9 unmanned ground vehicles are not able to perform the assigned tasks in the classical types of combat operations. What Binkov would like to accentuate is this: vehicles' shortcomings are not necessarily shortcomings of unmanned tanks. They may be a result of inexpensive components stemming from the need for an inexpensive and quick development process. Custom-designed components that proper tanks enjoy are much more expensive, designed to withstand the realities of actual combat. Today's technology could easily provide for durable tracks, stabilized fire platform on the move, and long-range identification. But it would make the vehicle more expensive. Uran-9 is still a developmental project, and keeping cost low was probably one of the priorities. The only aspect of Uran-9 that may prove to be problematic with even the more expensive tanks is the issue of control distance. Urban environments may indeed prevent long-range control. It is hard to assess how much dimensioned issues were due to possible fairly cheap communication equipment. While Uran-9 may not be much more than a counterinsurgent tool unsuitable for large-scale armored combat, it is but certain Russia and other countries will keep investing in bigger and better unmanned combat vehicles. And remember, Binkov may talk about hypothetical wars, but only real peace can bring us all together.